But you had the chance to check out the Paul Heyman DVD?
Yeah, I watched it twice, actually. I loved it. I thought it was great.
Yeah? You want to talk about it now or you want to talk about it later?
I just summed it up. I said I watched it twice and it was great. Obviously. No, it was... it was really good. You told me it was long. It was very long. Did I learn a lot that I didn't know already? Not really, but to hear it, you know, put in that context and from start to finish and covering the territories and all those old clips that I remember very well, just really kind of solidifies, you know, some people will say Bobby Heenan, but once again, and people have to realize this, Bobby Heenan was more of a worked manager. He, like even Rick Rude would say, he'd show up and he's manager then, and then they go to separate ways. Paul really hung out and nurtured his guys. Paul Heyman, Jim Cornette, and Gary Hart were three guys and Paul Ellering were guys who took the management role seriously, booked flights for the wrestlers outside of Matt, really managed the wrestlers' career, really gave them advice, really rode with them on travel, the highways and byways. Guys like Heenan and Jimmy Hart, they were worked managers. They didn't have any association with their wrestlers. Once they left that dressing room, then they went back, and that was it. So, I mean, that's why, you know, Heyman is in that, Paul Ellering, Jimmy Hart, Gary Hart, Jim Cornette, Gary Hart category of, you know, that's why the wrestlers respect him so much, because he really knew wrestling, and, you know, he was such a fan, and he wanted to be in any way he could. Started out, you know, reminds me of really how it should be in wrestling. You start out doing this or that as a young age and work your way up. Heyman's the epitome of that. I mean, 14, he was taking pictures at Madison Square Garden. I mean, Cornette, who was 16, taking pictures in Memphis. Almost a very parallel career, but obviously Heyman's much more successful. Not much more, but pretty much notable. More notable. Like I said, I knew all this stuff about him. I didn't know he was that young, though, at the Garden when he was... We pretty much were at some of those matches, Don Tony, during Morocco.
Yes.
Backlund. So sure. A young Paul Heyman was probably only feet away from us.
Yeah, it's true.
And
absolutely
I was watching
true.
Him on that Pedro Morales Magnificent Morocco, and I remember they had a series of three matches in a row, and I think I was at two out of the three of them in 1981, and you saw Paul Heyman right there next to Bill Apter. I was there.
Yeah, it's true.
So I
absolutely loved the documentary. And did you see that? See, now I think you understand why the Blu-ray is superior to the DVD.
There's
so many extras. And that second Blu-ray, if you people haven't picked it up yet, the second Blu-ray is awesome. Because WWE is starting to do something now that they missed the boat on a lot of the older documentaries. And the Blu-ray, especially the second disc, it had, you know, a lot of clips of his WWE stints, but there was story after story after personal story. And some of the stories, you know, no big deal, but, you know, hearing him drive Freddie Blassie's car at age 15 was pretty funny. And, you know, just getting a lot of those behind-the-scenes stories was really, really cool.
Well, I thought it was one of the stories of him no-showing Joey Styles' wedding and coming up with a lie that he's clinged on to for 16 years.
Yeah.
Now I thought it was funny. Like Joey Styles is like, Paul, just come clean. It's 16 years later, and he's sticking to the lie.
Yeah, Paul's sticking to the story. So, you know, it's a wonderful Blu-ray. It's a wonderful documentary. Not because I've always been a huge Paul Heyman fan, ECW and everything, but I honestly feel this is the greatest well-put documentary WWE's ever put together.
I put in my top five, along with CM Punk, Edge, the Monday Night Wars, and I'm trying to see what else. Mankind was pretty good, the Mick Foley story, but there's a lot of good ones. But CM Punk and Edge were always my two favorites. Paul Heyman would now be my top three.
Yeah, I would put in my top five, I would put Paul Heyman, CM Punk, Mick Foley, Edge, and the Monday Night Wars, I'm a little, hesitant about.